Today is September 11th, 20 years after the attack of the World Trade Towers and the Pentagon. For many of us, the phrase 9/11 churns up grief, pain, anger, and suffering. Therefore, today we turn from our daily scripture format to worship and pray for ourselves, the victims of and their families, and our once united nation that today is divided due to so many issues. Let us pray. The Holy Spirit gathers us into a community of prayer. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, the love of Christ that guards our hearts and minds, and the joy and consolation of the Holy Spirit be with you. Let us pray. You are gracious and merciful, O God, slow to anger, rich in love. Receive our prayers as you have promised, and uphold us by your Spirit until all things mended by your mercy are made whole and well in you. Through Jesus Christ, our healer and our hope. Amen. God speaks to us in scripture reading. From Paul's epistle to the Romans, the 8th chapter. What then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own son, but gave him up for all of us, will he not with him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, yes, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? No. In all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Word of God, word of life. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where will my help come? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in, from this time on and forevermore. The Holy Spirit prays with us and through us. Let us pray. Gracious God, the news of the day again has ripped our hearts and torn our souls. We are walking through the valley of the shadow of death as we remember. In the depths of pain and anger, we gather before you. O God, our rock and our refuge, you are our only comfort. You are our only hope. Merciful God, you know the depth of our suffering. Redeem our world. In Jesus' name, amen. Trusting God's word and promises, we pray in the power of the Spirit and in the name of Jesus Christ for the sake of all creation. O loving God, you know the needs of all the world. By your Spirit, grant that we, having turned to you in prayer, now might turn to one another in peace and tend and keep what you have made, and love our neighbor with the love of Jesus, in whose name we pray. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Go out into the world in peace. Have courage. Hold on to what is good. Return no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak and help the suffering. Honor all people. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And may God bless you and keep you. May God's face shine on you and be gracious to you. May God look upon you with favor and give you peace.